Hey, hey, what's happening? Ho, ho, ho. It's that time of year, right? We are at one of my favorite places in the world. Guitar Center, that's right. I bought my first keyboard at Guitar Center. My grandmother co-signed on the Juno, was it the 106 or the 60? I think it was the 60. That was the first, with the arpeggiator, with the wood grain sides. Anyway, that was my first keyboard back in like 1984 or something like that, right? And, or five, I think. And then the next one I got was a 106. Anyway, I digress. We're here. Let me show you guys. Check this out. It is Cyber Tuesday because it's not Monday anymore. But you know what? Cyber Day is no longer just a day. It's Cyber Week, right? But this one going through the 29th. So this is going to be over tomorrow here. But you know, there's a lot of other deals going on. The Black Friday deals, right? Through November 29th. But we're going to go in here and shoot some video. I already talked to the management. And they're cool with it. They know me. They know me already in this place. They know I buy stuff here and stuff. So I did go live earlier and shot video here live. But you know what happens when you try to go live in here. Johnny knows. Even when he's using Prism, which I can't use. I tried to explain that. Like, for some reason, I have two Music Therapy Laz channels. And both of them are attached to different emails. One's to my Laszlo email, and the other one's to my musictherapylaz@gmail.com email. And for whatever reason, that one has like two or three subscribers. The other one has like almost 800, which I'm hoping you guys help me out, man. Help me out. Get me to 1,000 this year, and I'll do a giveaway. I'll give away a guitar. But super secret on this video here. If you watch this all the way to the end, and I'm going to be giving out little Easter eggs along the way, so you have to watch it all the way through. I'm going to do a giveaway at the end of this. You have to leave some information in the comments, and then you will win something. Now, see, this is something I need to get. Because right now I have the speakers on these foam pad things, which are fine, but you know, they're not perfectly height set for the studio. Not that I have to be that perfect about it, do I? I mean, I'm not like, you know, super duper producer or nothing like that, but ideally, if you want to have your monitor set up properly, here's some really nice, these are really nice, right? Atom Audio also. Can't really go wrong with a set of these. And in my space, it's so small, I think that would be the max 7-inch. The 5s might even do. But I have some JBLs and I have my Les Pauls. I think the ones that we had in our studio back in the day were the 5-inch Yamahas. The NS, or 10-inch, I mean, the NS10s. 5-inch, but they got even tiny ones like that. So it depends on the size of your room, right? You don't need it to be too loud, right? But these are some nice audio production gear, right? Studio gear for listening back to your mixes. Now, Janice wanted me to check out the synth section, and I think she's looking for something with built-in speakers, which I don't know. I think the one that you bought, that mini Korg mini synth thing, the mini S thing, that thing's got battery operational and everything like that too. So I think you got a great deal on that. Look what they got here. So they got these Yamahas. I don't even know if these... So this is very similar to the one that I have, that Ladany I got for Ladany, my sweetie. You push this button here and it goes more like grand piano sound. You hear that? Yeah, man. Let's see. That's right. She's a little runaway. Oh, my goodness. So they've got music that's going to definitely copyright strike me if that's an issue. But I'm not going to say who it is. But it's some band from the 80s, which probably will. This is a really good piano, like controller slash piano. It's got piano. It's got organ. It's got all these things. It's got built-in speakers, too. The P125. Real nice action if you want like a piano. Yeah, I need more practice, Zach, right? Anyway, we've got all kinds of other keyboards here. Not on. But this is like, this is really not what you're looking for, Janice. I think you're looking for more a synth, right? Like, this is a Casio synth workstation kind of a thing. Maybe that's more, you want to modulate stuff, though. If you want to, like, tweak knobs and stuff, I think the one that you already got, I don't think you can beat that thing. The only problem with that thing is it's got them tiny keys. Got the mini keys, right? Okay, let's see if this, let's see if it goes by genre. Okay, just synths here. Here we go. Let's see what other sounds they have. These wheels, you turn the wheel, you get the other sounds. Let's see, it's a synth reed, synth saw. How does that go? I usually do that with the left hand, and I'm not holding a phone. So bad. Anyway, let's get back to it. So, they've got stands, they've got stools, they've got power cords, they've got other pianos, they got ladders. Anyway, what else do they got? So this is not really like the synth section, this is more like portable keyboard section, right? Yeah. So this looks like it's more, this looks like it might even have some speakers in it. So any of these speaker ones, you can turn them on. And just play them, right? Maybe we should turn them off. We'll be nice. Let's turn off the ones that we turned on. Okay, you gotta hold it on to turn it off, right? There we go. Let's turn them off. Let's be nice, because we're just burning batteries this way. That's not nice, right? Guy's probably watching me like, oh, that guy's turning on all the keyboards and he's gonna kill all the batteries and we gotta put new batteries in. And, oh. This looks pretty cool though, but let's see, how much is this one? Elisa's MK, that's something else. This Casio one, the tag is missing. But yeah, I have something similar to this one for Ladani. And she learned how to play Fleur, Elise at least. All right, let's see. Let's go move on out of the keyboard, portable keyboard section. Got pianos that says play me. Oh, real nice action. It's got a really nice kind of damper. Well, what do they call it? The oil dampered key. So it really kind of comes back at you just like a really good piano keyboard. Much better than this Roland one. Stiffer. All right. Oh, headphones. I think that's what you guys wanted me to look at too, right? Headphones. Well, they got used gear. So look at that. Well, this has pretty nice action too, the RD88 Roland. This does not have speakers, I don't think, does it? It's got some ports, some kind, a little dusty, but... Oh, nice! Nice. Any prices on this here? Let's see, it doesn't go, but these, I think some of these are the F, the RD, so this FP one, this FP30 is a used gear. So you can buy used keyboards here too. Oh look, this one even has the notes and everything on it, you guys. Ready to learn, ready to learn. All right, so headphones. You guys were asking about headphones. They do have headphones here. We've got Audio Technica, the AT-M2X. These are real tiny. Right, tiny, tiny ones. No prices listed there, but you can listen to them. Well, I guess this is it, right? Yeah, the M2. Well, this is the M2OX. I guess that's got to be it. No, this is the M20X. So there's this one here. It's $49. So this Audio Technica one right here. Okay. No specs. It just says exceptional value. Tuned to enhance low frequency performance. Alright. Then we've got the M30X tuned to enhance detail with excellent mid-range definition. Collapsible for space saving. Yeah, we can collapse these into itself like that, you know. More easy to transport, like if you're, you know, throwing that into a set of like a gig bag or whatever, right? Got your Audio Technica M40 here. So this one looks like it's got more swiveling capability here. So it swivels. So each one kind of ups the ante on like comfort and how it's going to fit your head and be usable, right? Probably these two are similar in their range of detail of sound. This one's tuned for flat, for incredibly accurate sound, monitoring across the entire frequency range. So good for probably mixing. And those are probably, well, they're not even that much. $99. And then you've got your pro model stuff here, it looks like. The M50X, $169. Oh yeah, these have really comfortable foam, like ear muffy thingies. These are the leather style ones, which feel pretty good too. They can get sweaty on you, you know? I prefer these kinds. Like I have those on my Beyerdynamics. My 990 and my 770. One's an open back, one's a closed back. Yeah, this is the one that I think Johnny has, right, Johnny? That was not cheap, bro. You got the most expensive one practically. Look at that. Well, not the most expensive one. But yeah, reasonably priced. And this has the swivel action, right? So, and this one also has exceptional clarity throughout an extended frequency range with deep, accurate bass response. So, critically acclaimed, right? So that's the $189. I don't know if there's a sale on these or not. Doesn't have anything listed, but you've got the higher end stuff here, the Astons. Those are gone. They already sold those, it looks like, but yep, these are the M40 to 50 to 60s. And that's your price on those Audio Technica headphones. So Yamaha also makes really, really good audio gear, right? So they've got some nice headphones here. You've got the no swivel here, no swivel here, no swivel here, no swivel. So no swivel, and they go for around $99 a piece, right? So different ones for different uses. It seems like different frequency responses. This one goes 20 to 20,000, right? Closed back, doesn't exactly say, but it looks like a closed back. So the difference being open and closed back, you guys, is a closed back doesn't allow any sound in from the outside. Open back allows some sound in from the outside. And sometimes you want that. Sometimes you don't. Sometimes you feel like a nut. Sometimes you don't. So this is like Pioneer DJ equipment, apparently. Never even seen Pioneer stuff. V-Moda. Don't know what V-Moda brand does. Ultrasone, haven't heard of them, but these look like they're expensive, so these are more like a pro level. You've got the swivel, see the swivel? The pro model swivel. This is light, it's got some nice padding, just right there, you know. That's where you need it, mainly, right? The Pro 480, difference. Being one has looks like blah 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 three-dimensional sound for the most accurate stereo feel. So this is great for like, well suited for EDM, hip hop, pop, and rock. Extended frequency range all across. This is probably more for listening. I don't know if it's as much for, say, like in the production studio kind of thing. Now the AKGs, all right, now here you're getting some stuff that for quality for the money, like these full 240s, these are classics, right? I remember back in the day in our studio, we had these because they're not expensive, right? But they're actually rated fairly good, you know, when it comes to, yeah, studio staple, right? That delivers pure sound with while eliminating ear fatigue. So, yeah, not the most comfy cup, though, you know. I prefer something a little softer. But, yeah, like, I have these. Oh, I have these. So I have the K553 MK2s right here. So this is, got two 50mm drivers. This is the one Johnny's like, what's those headphones you got on? That's what I was wearing, I think. Powerful and accurate bass response, 2D access mechanism. 2D. I guess enables fully flat folding for easy storage and handling, and closed back over ear design for noise isolation and maximum wearing comfort. Definitely comfortable. I don't know how much they're selling those for. Let's see. Please ask. So if they don't price it, then it's going to be higher than the next expensive one, which is the 371s. That's the K553, so obviously it's going to cost a little more than those. By the way, look around throughout the internet, you guys, on all these places selling stuff online. Guess how I got that set? I got that as like one of those stupid deals of the day by musician's friend or whatever. Whenever you see some deal like that, oh, here they are. No, that's not the right one. It's in the wrong spot. I thought, like, that can't be right, but that's the Sterling audio. Incorrect, sir. That's these. Right, these are $99, these Sterling. Sterling's, you know, one of those made in China brands, but I think everything's made in China now, right? Now you got your Bluetooth ones here now, right? So I think these are Bluetooth. Looks like. No, that's wired. Okay, just the black packaging. I couldn't see the wire. But yeah, so some nice headphones here. I have gotten these as crazy deals, stupid deals, like $35, $40 for some, just some cheap, you know, random, just practice kind of headphones. They're not the best, like, I wouldn't use those for, you know, production stuff at all, but just for listening or playing your guitar through whatever, yeah, it's fine. And they have different rated ones, so you get a little more volume on some versus some of the others. Like, there's a 300 that I think you get a little more volume out of, like, a guitar amp if you're plugging it into one of your setups that you might have. Like, I use that Roland, I mean, not the Roland, the Fender Mustang Mini amplifier kind of. Okay, so now we've got all kinds of drum stuff. Yeah, I've got a set of these, but the bigger version of those. Oh, here are the synthesizers. All right, Janice. All right, here we go. I don't know if these are all going to be turn-onable, though. Here's the button. It's plugged in. How do you turn it on? See, that's one thing that makes me nuts about keyboards. Like, you know, where's the button? It's usually going to be in the back here, like a little button push. I see the power cable right here. Oh no, that's just an alarm thing. Oh, so they don't have it plugged in, that's why. Alright. C'est la vie, c'est la guerre. Alright, then you've got like these kind of controllers. So I guess these are not going to make sound anyway, they're just controllers. That's why they're not plugged into anything, Laz. Look at the thing before you start talking. Anyway, so you got, you know, here too, a lot of online controller kind of gear up there. You've got, like, you know, like, this is like a very expensive, very, very expensive piece of gear here. Master level. This is the Nord. You see these on stages all the time, right? That's why I don't have one. It's like $6,000. More than $6,000 with tax, right? But this does a lot of stuff, so you can do your organ drawbar kind of adjustments and whatnot. I have that on my DS-88 as well, my Roland, but But yeah, the montage, you can get a Yamaha and you can play a montage, right? There you go. So none of these are the synthesizer kind of things that what Janice is asking about. These are more like stage and studio kind of like workstation things. I think you're looking more for performance kind of a thing, right? Something like this might be cool for you because, you know, but you already, oh, it says power back here. Oh, there we go. Ooh, lights. So something like this is cool because it's got like the drum pads right on it. And you can like do like, but that's why I recommended that Roland that I sent you a link to, because the Roland that I sent you a link to has, you know, the pads on it too, just six of them on the right hand side, I believe. And it makes it easy for you to like just throw together some loops and sequence some things together, right? But this is the Akai MPC Key 61. It's taking a little time to warm up. It's not properly shut down the last time you used the power. Don't correctly avoid data losses, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Somebody didn't start it correctly. Demo page to use, okay. See, this is sometimes the issue with these kinds of keyboards is it's like a, you know, workstation, so it's a computer, you know. It's got some issues coming back on. Trying to play the demo, that's not working, so. Dismiss demo page, boy, yeah. Too much curve to learn for that one, sorry. All right, so this is one of those Mode X here. This is not plugged into any, oh, there it is. It is plugged in, okay, we've gotta go master volume. Master volume is up. Speaker's right down here. It's going into this Roland kind of cube thing. I've never played that part with my left hand. That's always the right hand part. Anyway, so that's your Yamaha here. Let's see what other kind of tones this thing has in it. Oh, so that didn't do anything. Oh, yes, it did. Some nice like aftertouch. And yeah, this is more like a super duper performance keyboard here, right? Too bad it's not in stereo. So layered sounds and all that kind of stuff, right? It's got like a pad, piano and pad layer. You can do like whatever's programmed into these buttons, right? Thank you. All right, we're having too much fun here. We got to get to work. Oh, the DS88. So this is the one I was talking to you about, Janice. The Juno DS. So this is the full keyboard one, like I have, like piano version. It has an all right feel, you know. It's got like this pseudo, like it looks like ivory keys and nice feeling keys, but like compared to that kawaii piano over there, like the action is, it's good, but it's not as good as the other one. This one just dies pretty shallow, you know. The other one goes a little bit deeper, has a little bit more kind of control. And then I have this one too. Wow, how about that? So this is the V combo performance keyboard. Yeah, I gotta do more music, right, Zach? Yes, I've got to do more recording. Oh, look, more cowbell. All right, so we went over headphones for you guys. We went over some of the pro audio stuff. Of course, they've got, you know, the drum sets. So I bought one from the drum room here is pretty cool. I bought one from what is it called? Donner, and it had some issues. I gave it to my sister, and I bought the double like, you know, pedal setup and all from, what's that company? Not Tama. It's one of those typical companies. Not Gretsch. Not Evans. Not Remo. Not Pearl. I think it's like DP or something like that. So, I don't know. I'm not a drummer. But I love drums. I love playing the drums. So I'm going to help her set up her garage, Zildjian. I'm going to help her set up her garage so we can do some DW. I think it's DW. I think it is. I could be wrong. And then paste symbols. Could be pasty, but I think it's paste. Looks like the word paste to me, like toothpaste. Oh my God. Alesis, little, you know, these are nice electronic drum sets, right? I think what I need to do is buy a new brain for that other drum set, and then we'll be good, because that's the problem with that thing. It's just got a crappy D drums. It might have even been, so they have all kinds of cool accessories. So if you have a drummer in your family or somebody likes the drums or likes percussion things, there's all kinds of fun things. Shakers, professional grade shakers, you know. All kinds of cool stuff here. Tambourines with a nice comfy handle, right? And then your accessories and parts that people might need. This is definitely gonna give us a copyright strike if you guys hear this. This is that, you know, one of those bands that, you know, somebody owns them, and then they just come after you. All right, drums, drum parts, drumsticks. Then we've got acoustic guitars. Let's check out the acoustic guitars. There's nobody here today. Cyber Tuesday, and everybody's probably buying everything on the cyber, right? They're cyber purchasing. Oh, that's cool. Look at that black paisley looking Jaguar-y. $17.99. Whoa, made in Mexico? Nah. Well, that must not be. That can't be the made in Mexico one. Those are these ones. The made in Mexico ones are these $1,100 Acoustasonics. I actually bought my made in USA Strat style Acoustasonic for that price. So I got a good deal from Jams Music in Dublin. That's right. Buy from your local small mom and pop shop like I did. But you can buy from, you know, Guitar Center too. They got deals. They've got lots and lots of acoustic guitars here. That one's catching my eye just because it's a hummingbird. Epiphone, but you know, Epiphone 12 string. Epiphone was the brand back in the day, right? Oh, somebody downtuned the 12 string. Anyway, so these are really good little practice or, you know, stage amps, busking. But maybe more for practice, the smaller ones, and you got your, I think those are all the same size roughly. That one's a little bigger, right? So you got for your practice at home and whatnot. That's a nice Taylor right there. They've got Taylors here. They probably have some Cole Clark ones, maybe. Fender. Right? Mandolins. The mandolins I've seen in stores are like over $1,000 for the good kind, right? They usually cost a lot more than what you see, like these cheaper brand ones here. But yeah, look at the quilt on that one. That's a Mitchell store brand. So this clearance item Washburn here, it's probably made in China, but it's nice looking. Look at that. And for $239, right? It's got some electronics built in. It's got some issues on the fretboard, though. There's like a little hole over here. Not bueno. Yamaha. And of course, Martins. So you've got your quality Martin instruments up here. Very nice ones. Even this looks like a simple guitar, right? Ah, it's just a plain old mahogany top thing. What, how much could it be? $17.99. But I bet you it sounds good. Let's get up on it. Well, not with this in the way. See, I can't do this. Can't do this one-handed. Don't flip. Why do they do this? I wish I had some like gum, I'd stick it on there. Anyway, I'm kidding. Yeah. So I can't really test these out, but they have some nice deals here. Not great deals though. So not, you know, Cyber Monday, Cyber Week. You're looking for better than 15-20% off on stuff. You want like 50% off. You know, you want like, what's the crazy deal? I think these Washburns are not even that great of a deal. They're like $60 off. I mean, that's not that big of a price difference, you know. All right, so we're gonna go to the guitars, the electric guitars, the real guitars, and then we'll end this. And then we'll load it up, and then we'll delete it forever. Oh, that's a nice finish on that bass. Cool, right? Can't tell my glasses. Can't see. I can't tell. I think that's an Ibanez style bass. But yeah, they've got lots of bass guitars here, you guys. Cool stuff, right? Say eye-catching slime green or neon green Dean. That's pretty sick looking. Then you got your Squire Precision bass, which for $400 is probably a great beginner, or you know, you could gig with that. You got your Phoner, right? Or is that an Epiphone? Look at that, Epiphone. Oh, we got somebody's plugging in. They're about to get loud. A little baby bass here. Baby bass. And we got Player Series Fenders here. That one's pretty nice. That Cobra blue color right there, right? Yeah, see, that's an American Ultra bass. Look at that beautiful inlay there. That's nice. I'd like that one right there. Thank you very much. I'd take that. That's the one I'd take right now. If I was going to take a guitar and not have to buy it, that would be the one right there. That Cobra blue bass with the... Oh, look at the black binding. Oh, that's so sick. I want that. Ah, now I'm gassing for a bass. That's crazy. I'll be gassing for that now. All right. So we've got, you know, your Wallo guitars here, right? So these are all your guitars. We should start from the other end because... Let's shoot some amps and then we'll shoot the guitars. So one of the things I did want to say is you guys definitely should check out some of the other deals that are out there. So you can get a lot of cool deals at Pro Audio Star, Musician's Friend, which is affiliated with Guitar Center, same owner. There's Zounds, there's Sam Ash, there's Sweetwater, you know. They're gonna have deals. PRS blew out a bunch of guitars a little bit ago, right? Trying to clear out inventory. And Fender also did like a 25% off a lot of their stuff. So look at, they got Christmas tree. Pick it up and play it. That's right. I agree, Zach. I need to do that more. Pick up and play. These are cool. This is the cabinet for the St. James amps. We've got two different styles of those. This is a nice used piece of gear right here. There you go. Sonzera. Really, really, really nice amp. That one. Blackstar. Okay, here we're getting some heavy metal zone stuff here. $7.99 for this HT Metal series here. Right. One channel. But it looks like it's got two different overdrive channels, so it actually does have more than one channel. So it's 1, 2, 3 channel. So two overdrive channels on the clean. A lot of times the Blackstars, they just, you know, they give you a little bit of equalization, but that's it. And then this is cool. 525 Mesa Boogie Express. 1x12. Made in the USA. This is nice. I've always wanted a Mesa. I don't have one. Got a Vox though. The Vox is sick. Even though it's an older amp, it's a really nice one. It's not like a super vintage one or nothing. It's a made in China one, but these are great. I mean, this is like, you know, this. Yes. Yes, if you like rock and roll music, like if you like that stuff, like, you know, Queen or any of that kind of rock era, you know, pop rock stuff, U2, you know, any of that kind of stuff, Vox will do the trick for you. And then the Blues Cube, here you go. That's actually a really nice amp, Roland. Yeah, this thing looks brand new and it says used. How about that? Look at that thing. Oh, it's got a little dingage right there. So it might have been a displaced, and now they're selling it as used. This old Rickenbacker here, bass combo amp. That's seen some road action there from the look of that, right? And I don't know what this is. Looks like a kind of a homage to the good old little mini PV and other kind of toy amps. This thing's like less than one of them little toy things that don't sound good at all. It just sounds better than those things. I would plug into that just to see what it sounded like, right? Just to see. And let's check out the used section. So by the way, pickup wise, I think you were asking about that. They have a lot of parts here in the repairs section, right? And I've bought a few things from them here. When it comes to pickups, they don't have a lot of selection here, dude. We've got some, you know, Seymour Duncan hot rod humbucker set here. They have a few clearance items here. So they've got the Jazz, Seymour Duncan Jazz model for $69. So that's not bad, $30 off, right? It's almost 30% off. In the back there, they have some more little clearance tags, but I don't know for what. A whole lot of humbucker set there. And then you got your vintage Strat Seymour Duncan pickups here, some Hot Rail Strat pickups here. You got the whole 50s California Strat set up there. Fender's Tex-Mex set right there. I think that says $99 for the entire set. That's pretty cheap, right? And then right here you got your dime bag, dime buckers. You gotta get those, Brent. Put that in that new Les Paul you got. I'm giving away the secret. And then you got, you know, some of these other LR bags, of course, for acoustics, right? Yeah. And they got the Floyd Rose Rail Tail tremolo bridge there. Check out. It's a vibrato. It doesn't tremolo, it vibratos. And then you got your cleaning polish parts, tubes, EL34s there, some Tunsil, you know, 12 AX7s there. So if you need some tubes, they've got them here as well, you know. And then of course they've got stands, hangers. They probably have guitar docks here somewhere. This is the one thing I was thinking about getting. $89. That's better than anywhere else. Everywhere else I've seen this is $99. So trust Phil McKnight. He says that's the practice amp to go on the go. The perfect on the go practice XLR, amp right there. Like the Spark Go. I think I might buy that. So what you need is whatever device. Gonna buy it. Do I really need more gear? No. Really don't. I just need to hook it all up for y'all and play some stuff. But I'm doing this video for you, you know. I'm not doing this video for me. I'm doing this video for you guys, so you guys can see gear and see what you might want to get. Snark Air. This is also highly coveted in the gear world out there because it basically is weightless. You know, it's like a balloon, and it's like rechargeable. So, you know, 50% off rechargeable Snark tuner, right? So there you go, right there. It's toggleable. The top thing spins around, right? So I use, I have a Tease Electronic Unitune that I use, but I also have the Peterson Mini Tuner, and I have the new limited edition Peterson tuning pedal board tune or pedal tuner. And I have a couple of these others, like I have the Daddario, so I have some sitting around. I have some in my guitar bags so I don't forget, but usually when we're tuning up, we're just tuning up to each other, like give me an E, you know. So we've got Boss, of course, the Katana. Dang, look at that, a Mark II. I didn't know that these things were this expensive. I guess, you know, makes sense, right? Now, wow, look at this thing. It's very interesting. A Valve Train. Valve Train Trenton Pro Tube Combo. I've never even heard of this. It's got them chicken knobs. I love those chicken head knobs. Gotta get them chicken head knobs for my Flying Pickle pedal board. That's coming up next to being built. This looks like a used piece of gear. At least by the look of the, well, maybe not. Maybe it's just made to look vintagey compared to the newer looking. Let's see. Yeah. Hot Rod Deluxe. That's not bad. It's 25% off, you guys. Check that out. And it's brand new. Save $250 off. So that's pretty cool. That's a serious gigging amp right there. I think Johnny Bean used a Hot Rod Deluxe for a gig that I helped him out with. I just hung out with him and stuff and helped him, like I was his roadie for the day. It was cool. Alright, let's go ahead and hit the use section. Hit the use section, and anytime you have any musician in your family, these accessories like cleaners, strings, all that, you can't lose. Just, you know, ask them what gauge they use, but if you don't know what to get them a gift card, you know? Oh no, this song's definitely gonna... I wish there was a way to mute this. How do I mute it? How do I mute it? I can't mute it. Okay, that's too bad. Alright, so I might have to mute it afterwards. Yeah, but you guys hear the song that's about to come on, right? Yeah. And the speaker's like right up here, too. So look at this used PRS. SE Whale Blue. For $424, and you get to try it out right here. It's got Seymour Duncan in the bridge, so they upgraded this a little bit, right? That's a nice little guitar there for 400 something bucks, right? Plus tax, under 500. There you go. And they got a lefty up there too. And then we've got this Epiphone Les Paul for 500 bucks. I'd get that. Get that before you get this, because that's a better guitar by far, right? I mean, really, really nice, right? Ibanez. An Ibanez E335 style kind of thing going on here. I'm going to get up on the ladder here. This is a JSM. Alright, used gear for $9.99. And then here you got some Jackson reverse headstock. Hey, Ron. This is a really cool guitar, but you can't take it because it's got Jackson in pink on it. Oh, no, no good for you, man. Now, here's a nice little Fender American Original, just the white Strat, right? The original, the white Strat. New old stock, right? So NOS, is that what that says? Or is that, oh, it says 5OS 50s. Oh, original 50s Strat, made in America, 2020, right? Yeah, that's cool. Looks cool. Locking tuners? No. It's too bad. But yeah, it's a 50s style, so of course it's not gonna have locking tuners. It's got the old style bridge. You just drop a Vega trim in here, man, and you're good. All right. Squire for $99 almost looks the same as that. But that's sick. That's the white guitar, right? The white Strat. Sorry. Blocking some other people looking, wanting to look at guitars. thin line style, another PRS there, used nice looking walnut. Walnut guitar there for like $699. So I think this is the year to, you know, you can get some really great deals this year. Really. I really believe that. There's some really nice guitars over here. Yeah. And my buddy Brent just traded his V for a really nice Les Paul, so there you go, man. Look at, here's the Les Paul, and he got a way better deal than this. He got a way better deal. I'm not saying how much, but I know. Anyway, right on. All right, so let's go ahead and go through the rest of this year. And I think you guys have seen this. This is probably going to get copyright strike because of this, but I love that. That black, look at that, AAA top flame, black burst, or what would you call that, I don't know, trans black. Pretty, pretty cool, right? I'd take that one. That's the one I'd want off the wall here. If they have a white Falcon. This is one of the G2627s. Well, for the money, it's probably a pretty cool guitar, right? Hag's drums are pretty cool as well. And not too terribly priced either. Look at that. The clearance. Now there you go, there's the deal. $500. $500 off on this thing. That's pretty cool. Yeah, man. Alright. Let's keep looking. This is gonna be a long video, you guys. It's the first time I've been back to Guitar Center doing something like this, so. Oh, look at that Kramer.
The Pacer series. Alright,
it's made in China, I believe. Well, a lot of stuff nowadays, like most of these guitars, except for maybe the Schecter is made in Indonesia, I would bet. You know, $100 off there, not too bad. You got all your beautiful Les Pauls up here. So that oxblood colored one right there is pretty cool. Look at that. That's what they call that color, right? Something like oxbone or oxblood or something of the sort.
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry, no worries. Careful there. Yeah. Oh. There it is. The Relic Frankie, $19.99. I got a deal on mine, dudes. Mine looks better than that, too. And I got the blue paint and the thingies on the back. What do they call them? Sparklers? Reflectors? I'm just messing with the Van Halen nerds because they're going to be like, yeah, you don't know nothing. No, I don't. I don't have to know everything. I know what I need to know. Anyway. That's pretty cool. That's just such an 80s. The Striker. With that Kramer logo. I love that Kramer logo. So cool. Yeah. Does not have fret sprout. Nice, soft, very comfy, flattened out kind of C-shapey neck. I mean, that's a nice feeling neck. It's not quite like an Ibanez, but it's flatter than like most of your you know, other Strat style guitars, right? And it's got the you know, the cutout for that, so you don't have to do your own, and then you just change all the parts. And yeah, that's all you really need to do. Assuming that my earbuds are what you guys are hearing through the phone here, but maybe not. It's probably the mic on the phone, which might be better. Yeah. You know, they're doing some good things made in China. I mean, looks nice, right? Look at that Cutlass. Sterling Cutlass. Jason Richardson Cosmic. Purple, maybe? The Richardson. I don't know who he is, but he has a guitar in his name, Poplar Burst, or Poplar Burl Burst, and Purple Poplar Burl Burst. Say that five times real fast. Spoke wheel adjustment where it should be. Real nice feeling. Made in Indonesia, of course. Yeah, this is a great deal, you guys. This guitar is cool. Cool guitar. Normally $9.29, Get it for $6.99. $300 off, man. Well, it says $230. Oh, that, yeah, $9.29 and $6.99. Okay, that was $9.99. But very cool. That's cool. I dig that. And custom dinged by Laz just now. Oh my goodness. So, look at that beautiful three-tone sunburst. Ultra strat made in the USA. This one looks like it's a, let's see, it's, what does it say? Why is it so much? Tom DeLonge. Okay, so this is the Tom DeLonge Daphne Blue. $12.99, I bet you that's made in Mexico, right? Hardtail, notice, no stick. And you got some Jacksons, you got that shell pink strat up there, that's pretty cool. That's a nice one, I like that. That like silver fade, that's cool. They're professional. Pretty cool. You got your tomato soup Mustang body. What do they call those things? The amoeba shape. And this is my favorite. This is my all-time favorite one. It just needs a humbucker and a bridge. Right. The ultra and cobra blue. 2-point blocking system, just change that out for a Vega trim. Put in some other pickups, maybe. Yeah, I love that antique finish or vintage finish neck. And it's probably have to knock the finish off. If it's not already satin, it should be, you know, but if it's not. But yeah, that's one of my favorites. And then you've got the Dark Knight series here, right? That's what they were calling them. Look at that kind of semi-blondish looking kind of thing there. It's pretty cool. Butterscotch, I think, maybe, right? Pretty cool. And then we've got the Ventura series. Is that what that is? Yeah. The Ventura series. Now, this one is actually ash. Not the prettiest joint there. But sometimes you can't control that, right? And some more, like the couple different green colors up there, seafoam, and I'm not sure what that one is. I think that's the seafoam, and that's some other kind of. That's like, no, that's a custom. Oh, that's that Johnson one, right? That little Johnson, what's his name? Yeah. So slowly fade over, yeah. Played that one. That's been here forever. That's a cool guitar though. And then here's like, you know, maybe a real vintage or a vintage relic guitar. And then you got your SGs. That one's cool. I like Silververse. Not everybody likes Silververse. I dig it. But you know, if I were to get an SG, I'd just get the Tony Iommi one. Because why not? Anyway, that's it you guys. I'm going to head on out. We can go by the pedal section real quick too on my way out. What do you guys think? This is almost like a 1 hour video. 1 hour. 1 hour of video shooting here. Gamma pedals. Gamma, gamma, gamma. Hey, I know it's Gabba. I'm just joking. I'm not sure who Gamma is. But we got the Line 6 Pod Go. Right? I got the Line 6 Pod Stomp or whatever it's called. That's kind of this with a little extra something, right? And I got an OD1. Thank you for that, my good friend from up north, the Hobo Roadie. Well, you can try these out. Check them out. So you just put this in your mouth, and you stick that in your ear. That's how you hear it. You stick that in your ear, and you just, you know, listen to the different sounds. Kidding. I think you have to have some headphones. I'm not sure how this all works, but very useful. Metal Zone, everybody's favorite pedal, right? This is very useful as well. Also useful. Gotta have one of those. Oh, that'd be fun to have, right? Harmonist. And then loop stations, these are great. And then you got your RV6, your DD7, classic DD3, right? And then I'm not sure what this is, a Waza craft.
Oh, Waza DM2.
Waza. Very cool. You got all the boss stuff. Well, actually, there's like thousands of those, right? There's like so many different kinds. I think Henning was showing us this brand new pedal out that's out called the Tube Screamer. They even have a pillow. Anyway, I think this is where my buddy Brent bought an orange, like, preamp pedal of sorts, right, dude? Yeah. But they have, you know, your Walrus Audios. Very nice. They got your fundamental chorus, reverb, delay. And then you've got your Monument. That's going to probably be some way more deep delay kind of reverby things, right? It says shape, so might be some kind of reverb. I don't know. Might say right here, doesn't. Harmonic. So maybe it's some kind of a tremolo thing. It's got, oh, okay, it could be some kind of modulation thing, right? Because it's got depth and shape. So, you know, different kind of wave forms, right? Your classic Phase 90, but not the script logo. I mean, analog, sparkly blue chorus, which is cool. Classic overdrive. MXR makes great pedals. Fat Sugar. I like it. It's pink. Ron, it's pink. It's probably the best pedal in the box here. Anyway, you got your carbon copy, right? And we got some OBD Deluxe Friedman pedal here. $269. I suggest spending a little more and getting the new preamp pedal that they have, but this is different. This is goes in front of your amp. The other one can go into your I guess your effects in, right, and out. Do it that way. The Rat, these are classics. The Ego compressor by Wampler here. Distortion, right? And these came out last year, right? These Maestro pedals are back. Very cool. Here's a nice pink one for you, Ron. It's a lot of pink is definitely in fashion, dude. I don't know. Maybe you're gonna have to rethink that. Oh, this is the most famous one here. The one that either you love or hate the name. The Horse Meat. And then you got the Wind Through the Trees. I guess Wind Cries Mary kind of thing. Oh, and then the New X. The New X. If they just put a gap between the new and the X, people would call it New X, but there's no gap. There's just like an arrow, and so you read it like nukes, right? So, you guys, marketing suggestion, just move the NU over about a space, right? And then people will read it as New X, not nukes. Simple. Just solved your biggest problem right there. But maybe you want it that way, so people talk about it, right? So the Strobo Stomp HD, there you go. Very cool pedal for tunage. And then you got mini pedals here, which are more expensive in some cases than the bigger brothers for some reason. But yeah, they've got some interesting Pictronics ones here. And then you got the Keeley Fuzz Bender. Very cool. That's on sale. It's about $25 off. We got the compressor. I think you were asking about that, right, Ryan? Keeley compressor. I can't lose with that. I've got a Plumes, but I've got a green one. This is a nice kind of candy apple red version. I like it. And special cranker. That's called the Afterneath. And then you got some more Boss pedals here. And then the Big Muff. Who can't use the Big Muff, right? And I'd love to have one of these B9 organ or one of these kind of like, you know, PHX or Electro Harmonics, right? One of these funky kind of organ or synth or whatever kind of pedals. Morley. Talkbox. I don't know if we'll ever use one of those. All right, and then we got the Hall of Fame. The intelligent harmony machine. That's pretty cool, right? The Benz by Fender. And some other interesting Abassi pedals here. Pathos. Eterna. I've never seen that one. Mr. Black something? Mr. Black Petals, I guess? And the Wallace Radio Aegis. There we go. Switchblade. I've got the Switchblade Pro. It's a bit bigger than that. And I have used it. Oh, look at that. This is an old school one, like the one I have. I have one of these. Never used it. I know, it's nuts. Yep. And then we got the Head Rush, the Boss GT1000. These are all these multi-simulator effects type pedals. So, and then, you know, slides. You can't go wrong with some of these kinds of things. They can bring it back if it's not the right size and exchange it, right? Power adapters, things like that. I highly suggest paying a little more and getting, you know, a good one, like the True Tone One Spot. Very, very good. And then you've got all your, like, work on your guitar kind of stuff here. Tools, sound hole covers for playing your acoustic without feeding back, all that kind of stuff. Right? I've got one of these. These are nice for keeping your guitars clean, right? And stools. You can always use a bar stool, right? I wonder how much those are. Anyway, but I've got plenty of those. And like your little amp cart. Just throw 200 pounds of stuff onto that thing. Just drag your amps and straps. Capos or capos if you're in Italy. And that's it, you guys. All right, let me get this turned back on me. So, flip the phone. Oh, here we are, Guitar Center. Just did our post Black Friday Cyber Week cables and the like, right? Cyber Week video. No time to play any guitars or anything right now, but I'm gonna show you some more cables. Harmonicas, cable adapters, and you know, new plugins. If yours go bad, you can redo them. Mic cables, of course. T-shirts. Get your gear here. I think I have one of these. When I washed it, it totally shrunk. It's like so tiny now. I bought one of those last time, I think. So, yeah. Slayer! I should get those for my sister. But they're what? $29 now. They can't be. They gotta be $13, right? Slayer socks for Monica. Yellow submarine socks for me. Oh, these Fender socks are kinda cool. Kiss. Alright, so that'll be it, you guys. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I know it's long. My battery power's running out and I'm over an hour already. Oh. Microphones, real nice studio microphones. There we go. Alright, so that's it, you guys. Hope that this fulfilled your need of gear perusing at Guitar Center. Maybe I should do some other stores over the next week or so. They had some cool used guitars up there, but nothing. That one PRS kind of had my eye, and I am wearing a PRS sweater. So that might hint to the future. But no shenanigans today. No shenanigans today. I'm going to get home and get some more work done. Until next time, you guys rock. Love you all, man. Thanks for watching my videos. I appreciate all of that. Especially, you know, this time of year. This is supposed to be about family and giving and love and all that. And there's some bad things happening in the world. So try to, you know, make friends with each other. Don't hate on each other. And try to give more love to each other through music especially, and I hope to do more of that, of course. So next time on the channel, I'm going to be doing my gear and demo show this Thursday. I'll be doing a little bit of a one against the other kind of pedal, just to see what they can do differently, right? I recently got the Warm Audio Mutation Phaser, which is a really unique phaser. Based off of like some old style 70s thing. Brent said, get that instead of the other one. So I got it and I watched a couple videos since, and it does seem really, really cool. So I thought it would be cool to put it up against the Walking on the Moon pedal. So I asked Johnny to bring that. So he's going to bring it to me tomorrow, drop it off for me. And then yeah, Thursday night I'll be playing those through hopefully the interface. If not, it'll be like your same kind of cheesy demo as usual, without perfect sound and all that. But eventually this Christmas I'll have a little more time to get some of that together for you all, so you have some better quality audio when I'm shooting demo videos, right? So I hope you appreciate the extra hour I put into this, because I tried to do it live, no good reception, wasted about a half an hour on that, outside of just chatting with you guys, which was cool because I got an idea of what you wanted me to look at. Just look at everything, right? And we'll see you on the Thursday show. Tonight, Johnny Bean's got his Tuesday night, right, show in a little while, so go check that out. It's, I guess, exclusively Van Halen show on the Johnny Bean TV multimedia media circus, or whatever you want to call it. media extravaganza. his empire that he's putting together. And then of course you've got my friend Martin and Lucas, my friends Martin and Lucas, on their show on Thursday actually, before my show. They do an afternoon, like around noontime. And then actually my buddy Brent tomorrow, he's got his Octopus Ears, Octopus's Garden show. So go check that out, you guys. So until next time, peace out. Music Therapy Laz saying rock on from Guitar Center. Cyber Week. Later. Hey, it's Music Therapy Laz. I forgot to mention what the secret, you know, prize / giveaway thing at the end of the video is supposed to be. Driving home, I just realized, oh my God, I forgot to do that. So what I want you to do is, into the comments of this video, post which guitar did I say that out of all the guitars that were there I would have bought today if I was really looking to, you know, spend some money, shenanigans, out of the used section, okay? Out of the used section, and I'll give you a hint, it had a Seymour Duncan humbucker in it, but normally those don't come with those. And it was about $440-something. So I think I mentioned, after looking at that, for under $500, you could get that really cool guitar. I thought it was a really cool guitar. It is a single cut style guitar. That's another hint. And another hint is, I am wearing the sweater. So if you've been watching the video throughout, some point along the video I mentioned the sweater as well that I'm wearing. It's the same brand. So the same company, the brand of sweater I'm wearing, is the brand of that guitar, all right? So put it into the comments and you'll win a prize. And then I'll do it this way. If there's more than one person in the chat that gets the name of the guitar, or the type of the guitar that it is, correctly, I will then on Thursday's show put your names on the wheel, right? And spin the wheel, and then that's how it's going to choose one of you guys, all right? It's probably not going to be a lot of people to choose through, but if between now and Thursday, you guys got 2 days, man. Well, almost. Well, actually, yeah, two full days, all right, before the 7 o'clock show. A little bit even more than 2 days. More than 48 hours. You got like 52 or so hours. So you have about 52 or 3 hours to figure out that brand. You don't even have to say the exact guitar, just the brand, all right? But the exact guitar would be cool, but just the brand is cool. And then you will win something. I don't know what, but it's going to be cool. Because, you know, Christmas is almost here. We're going to have 12 days of Rockmas coming very soon. So that's very exciting, right? So that'll be cool. I got to get some gifts. Got to get some gifts for you all. Normally, I buy those during the Black Friday deals. You know, I buy up a bunch of stuff. And there's still cyber deals out there. So I'll probably do that, you know. I bought headphones. I bought, you know, string sets. I bought guitar docks. Maybe I should buy a bunch of guitar docks, right? Those are great. Guitar docks, cables, capos. I don't know. What else? What else is around that $10 to $20 range is usually what I do with those, right? And then, if by chance you guys help me reach 1,000 by the end of the year, and it doesn't look like it, but, you know, you guys can mad rush get a bunch of your friends to sign up onto my my subscriber list or whatnot. And if we hit 1,000 this year, then I'll do a free guitar. I'll buy and give away a free guitar. And I might even mod it up with some of the parts I already have that are good parts and replace the bad parts, because I'm going to buy a cheaper guitar, right? But I'll buy something, you know, playable, right? Something usable, like one of them Kramer Beretta specials. That would be cool, right? Maybe I'll even paint it and mod it for you like I'm doing CCs, right? So if you guys think that's cool, that would happen if you guys can get me to 1,000. But we're about 220 subscribers away. So I think it took Johnny Bean, it takes him like an entire month to maybe get a couple hundred like that maybe. So he might be shooting for a lot here. But, you know, you got to shoot for the stars to hit the moon, as they say. So I guess I should end this.